This is the 1-inch Leica edition of the Insta360 ONE R. I'm back, baby, with an updated review and comparison versus the GoPro 8. Now, huge thanks to Insta360 for sponsoring today's video. They've made some big improvements and pushed out some major firmware updates to this camera and 1-inch sensor, and today we're gonna check it out. Let's do some pixel peeping at that 5.3K resolution video, daytime and low light shots, night mode, dynamic range, and the flow state stabilization at nighttime, time-lapse, and a lot more. Now, I'm Ben from AuthenTech. Buckle up and let's jump right in. Starting with resolution, this 1-inch sensor can record up to 30 FPS at 5.3K. That's 5312 by 2988. In contrast, standard 4K cameras, like what the GoPro 8 maxes out at, is recording UHD 4K, which is 3840 by 2160. So the 1-inch sensor has a lot more pixels and data to play with. Now, as we compare and contrast some of this footage, here's some things to note. Firstly, the 1-inch mod that I received a few months back was a pre-production unit, so it seems Insta360 has worked out some of its kinks, and like I mentioned, pushed out a lot of firmware updates. Now that I have a production unit in hand, these are some much improved results, which is great to see. In this very first shot of the tree, both of these cams are looking pretty good, but a constant theme throughout this video I notice, at first glance, they look pretty comparable. Even the GoPro footage looking pretty okay. But when we play back the video at full 4K res and start to zoom in and inspect the tiny details, well, the differences will become a lot more apparent. Like zooming in here, 300% on those tiny little branches and tree needles. Even comparing the blades of grass, there's a fair bit of extra clarity and detail on the 1-inch over the GoPro 8. We gotta remember that those extra 5.3K pixels on the 1R means we have a much larger sensor size, of course, as well. 1-inch versus the GoPro's smaller sensor size. Another thing Insta360's been working on is improving their color science, and this is a great shot to show that off. GoPro's known for that punchy, contrasty look right out of the camera, and sometimes it's not bad, but then other times it can be a little bit too much, oversaturated. The oranges can be way too unrealistic, like seen here. I prefer the more realistic colors on the 1R. The fence color looks much better and more accurate in real life. Plus those blue skies, while GoPros like to saturate those blues a lot as well, the 1R is looking a bit more realistic. If we magnify and zoom 500% on the bird feeder, I'm seeing a lot more details on the 1-inch. And one more daytime shot. This was captured here in my studio, natural light coming through a large window. They both were looking pretty similar at first, nice white balance and dynamic range. But then when I punch in 400%, there's some really interesting results. Firstly, the GoPro comes out pretty mushy looking, even in the plain textures like the white paint. It has some digital noise going on and the pixels are starting to break down. In the end, it kind of results in this soft, grainy image. Now, on the other hand, I was really impressed and even surprised with how different the 1-inch looked. It's a much cleaner image with more clarity in those tiny details, a lot less grain and noise. It's pretty sharp looking. When I pan over to the dark sofa and the YouTube cushion, let's zoom in 400% again, and I prefer the 1-inch side better. Cleaner noise, even the whites look more pure, sharper details as well. Here I went out to capture some beauty B-roll shots in the daytime, bright sunlight. When playing back on a 4K monitor, I was really impressed with the results. The sharpness and clarity of all those micro details in the pixels never gets old. And I gotta remind myself, this is a 14mm ultra wide angle lens, which for wide angles are notoriously known for softer details. Even the latest iPhone 11 Pro, for example, its ultra wide lens, it looks very cool, but you'll often sacrifice clarity for that wide field of view. With this 1-inch, I'm not only getting that ultra wide lens, but I'm still getting some great sharpness and clarity at the same time. Another thing I like to do on this 1R, since it's recording these INSV files even after I record the video clip in both their mobile and desktop studio, I can set the field of view that best suits my shot. So sometimes I like the ultra wide to squeeze in the full landscape into frame, but then another favorite of mine is linear. It punches in a little bit, straightens out the camera curve, keeping those horizons and verticals straight. Plus, it just makes the footage look like it was shot on a much higher end DSLR or mirrorless camera. It's really beautiful and impressive video. Now let's quick talk about the minimum focusing distance. They say it's about 90 centimeters, which is this. Now if I hold it out handheld, that's not reaching the 90 centimeters at arm's length, so we have a problem. So instead, I mount it on their selfie stick, for example, and then we're for sure hitting that 90 centimeters minimum. My face and everything behind me will be in focus. And don't forget, this lens is fixed focus, which means everything from that 90 centimeters to infinity is gonna be in focus. So this doesn't make it good for close up tight angle shots, but we can still shoot some really pretty B-roll footage. Now in this one example, I sort of use it to my advantage, and I set the field of view to narrow, place the camera right up close to this park bench so it'd be slightly blurred and out of focus, and then the lake and the homes and the background were in focus, producing almost like this fake tighter depth of field like lens shot, which is kind of cool. Plus, not to mention the impressive dynamic range going on under the tree shadows as well. Funny how my horizon got a little bit tilted with my unleveled tripod, so this is a good time to show off the feature of shooting in 5.3K resolution. Here on a 4K timeline, we can add a little bit of rotation, scale up the footage just a few percentages, and then we're technically not degrading the resolution, as the original clip is larger than 4K. It's a nice bonus to have. The ONE R 1-inch produces these beautiful time lapses, really sharp clarity, and beautiful natural colors. Plus, again, we have 5.3K resolution to play around with, so a simple Ken Burns push in or pull out effect to add some extra depth and motion to the time lapse. I'm not degrading the footage at all, and it looks really good. I mean, just look at the details in the water ripples, it's really impressive. In this shot under the trees, the sun was just starting to peek out from behind the clouds, and I went handheld with the ONE R, made sure flow state stabilization was turned on, set field of view to linear, and this shot looks pretty dang sweet. Beautiful colors and dynamic range, both in the shadows and the dark tree bark and under the canopy of the leaves, but nice soft highlight fall off in the clouds and in the water reflections. I was also impressed with how smooth the shot turned out since it was a handheld pan, but turned out looking really stable. Under the weeping willow, this was a pretty difficult shot for a camera with lots of constant moving tiny details, and I think the 1-inch performs quite well. We can make out each and every vine, count them if you'd like. Time and time again, I tried to place the 1-inch R under some tough lighting, contrast, and sharpness tests, and its clarity and performance was really impressive, especially when I remind myself all of this is coming out of a tiny action camera that can fit inside my pocket. Now, before we jump into the sunset and dusk and low light night shots where it gets super interesting, I want to quick compare some photos first, starting in the daylight. And no editing applied to either. I'm seeing some of the same results again when we zoom in, better detail and sharpness on the 1-inch. In this tree shot, HDR was turned on and we're seeing a little ghosting on the 1R, but to its credit, we can still see more clarity in the veins of the leaves, which is pretty cool. In this indoor studio shot, similar results again. I prefer the cleaner and sharper image out of the 1-inch 1R. GoPro's tiny sensor just can't really compete. Now let's move on to some golden hour and sunset shots, as this is where the 1-inch really starts to shine. In this first shot, I went down to the lake and the orange colors were popping off. And at first glance, my eye was kind of drawn to the GoPro. But the closer I looked and I noticed with its harsher contrast and punchy saturation, it was at the cost of some loss of detail. Plus, if we zoom in anywhere on the screen, it's a little soft and blurry looking. I think the 1-inch is definitely the more professional route. Another thing I noticed when viewing here top and bottom, the ultra wide field of view of the 1-inch is even wider angle than the GoPro, which is perfect when viewing a wide landscape shot like this here at the lake sunset. In this shot of the black swans, let me just highlight the sharpness differences like seen here in the grass blades, in the water ripples, tree branches. As the sun keeps going down, it's getting much darker out, and this is honestly where almost all cameras struggle, and it helps a lot to have a larger 1-inch sensor. A few things you can notice on the smaller GoPro sensor, as the light dips, there's gonna be a lot more noise and grain in the video. The shadows will be coming a lot more muddy and soft. The 1R is coming out a bit cleaner, sharper, and even a brighter exposure, which is nice. Another cool feature of the 1R, in video mode, I can check this box for low light stability, which I turned on here versus GoPro's HyperSmooth, and it's a pretty major difference. Actually, a lot bigger difference than I thought. It's much better looking on the 1-inch, way more smooth and stable. Electronic image stabilization in low light is usually a tough feat, but the 1-inch is coming out on top with better highlight control, dynamic range, less noise, more details, and it's avoiding blur on the strong light points like seen here in this lamppost. And then we go into nighttime. It's really dark out there. While the GoPro is doing an okay job of seeing a little bit of those details in the shadows, looking at the quality of those details or even in the blue night sky, it's crazy noisy and grainy, mushy and soft. On the 1-inch, this is default settings, of course, no post-editing applied. The shadows look a bit darker, but it's a much sharper image. Even compare the bright light from the lamppost, major difference between the two. When handheld walking, again, much smoother and impressive stability on the 1R with less motion blur. Even as the geese fly overhead, it's a fun shot to capture as the 1-inch makes them appear a lot more clear over the GoPro. Not to forget some of those sunset and dusk photos. These really pop and showcase the differences. Well, there's crazy lot more detail and sharpness in the 1-inch photos. It's straight out of camera, dynamic range looks really good too. Some of these weren't even shot in its RAW or HDR mode, yet they still look really good. One of my favorite things to do is zoom way in on these photos and the differences come alive. As it grew more and more dark out there, the GoPro kept getting more and more grainy and noisy, almost looking like an oil painting sometimes. The 1-inch performed quite well and basically almost always looked like the better image. I made sure to turn on night mode on both of these cameras as well. Now, one cool thing the 1R has is night mode. And so under photos, we select night mode, and with this 1-inch mod, that 1-inch sensor is gonna really help and produce some awesome shots. And then I like to turn on JPEG plus RAW. So when we do that, it's gonna capture 9 of these RAW DNG files. Then over on the computer, we'll select 9 of those DNG RAW files, drag them into the Insta360 Studio desktop app, does a little bit of processing, some magic going on in the background, and then this final merged image looks crazy good. From here, we export resolutions and a few settings here. It cranks out pretty fast, and there it is. That's the JPEG. It looks like it tone maps it a little bit, and that's the raw DNG. If we bring that into Photoshop, let's say, we're gonna have a ton of sweet editing control in here. Bring up the shadows a bit. Jack up the vibrance, bam, that starts to really pop. Again, customize and play to your liking, but then look at, when we zoom in, look at the clarity on here. That looks really good out of what I'd say is a tiny action camera. In these final night shots, to keep it fair, these were combined JPEGs from those night shots. The 1R shots would look even better if I had edited them in the raw DNGs in Photoshop. Final notes I wanted to share. One of my favorite features of the 1R is its modularity. It's not just a single 4K wide or 1-inch sensor lens camera, but we can pop off the battery, snap it off, snap on a new mod like this 360 lens, and then bam, we're off to the races. We can bundle it, customize it to your liking. Part of this major benefit is future potential and expandability. Plus, if you ever need a selfie monitor, there's no need to purchase anything extra. GoPro, just pop off the screen, flip it around, and boom, you're good to go. I often get the question from my viewers, which app do I prefer, the Insta360 or the GoPros? And hands down, it's the Insta360s. There's way more potential in editing, and another favorite feature of mine is the smooth timeline scrubbing. Watching back my video clips without ever needing to copy them over. This is all happening wirelessly over Wi-Fi. If you need the highest 5.3K resolution exports out of your 1-inch, then you'll need to use their desktop studio app, which has been improved over time. This will convert your files over, and do note that these 5.3K files, they aren't for the faint of heart, and processing all these clips can take a little bit of time. You'll probably want a good PC or Mac to process through all this. I'm working on a 10-core iMac Pro, 64 gigs of RAM, and it's still no easy load. And one last thing I wanted to mention, Insta360 recently launched a trade-up program. So if you have any old action cameras laying around, you can send them in and swap them out for credit towards a new 1R. It's a nice option to have. If you guys have any questions or details you want to share, leave me a comment down below. I always try my best to respond if and when I can. Thank you guys so much for watching, and consider sticking around for a lot more tech videos I post at least once a week. Until I see you next week, let's live AuthenTech.